to introduce the speakers. 8 months ago, approximately in Jena, city town of Jena, we had a climate conference, high-ranking conference, 200 years of climate station in Jena, which is in the inner city, a weather station in the middle of Jena. Today, formerly it was on the outskirts, and which is, there was a presentation in the agenda with two female authors, which actually we didn't know, never heard about, the two, and we were very impressed, and I actually dared ask the authors whether they would be willing to come, either yesterday or today, to come and hold the same paper and presentation to enrich our discussion. They declared themselves ready, but on the other hand, the extended secondary schools in Saxony have the A-level examinations. This has something to do with our two authors. However, one has fallen ill, and the other will hold a speech, Summer in the City, Climate Change in the Town of Jena. Julia Fleischmann, the floor is yours.
And if you push some of these buttons, you will see your presentation right away.
Ja, also vorerst vielleicht noch meine Freundin, also
at the
meine
beginning,
eigentliche Mitreferentin ist krank
my friend
geworden,
and co-referent has fallen ill, so it's not possible for her to be here today. She has a very terrible cold and that's why we have a substitute. And now we try to tell you also the part of Juliane.
Der Klimawandel ist eine ganz besondere Herausforderung
so
für uns
climate
Menschen,
change is an a special challenge
also
for
dessen,
our for people because this is a side effect of our wealth.
Mehr Bequemlichkeit,
so more we
mehr
also wanted to have more luxury, more comfort, more consumption, but because of modern technologies
sich,
and the use of resources,
Folgen
it was possible, but now the impact will threat our life space. So this was a quote of Professor Dr. Hans-Joachim Schellnhuber, and so I want to start my presentation with this quotation.
Zuerst möchte
first of all,
ich Ihnen das Projekt, an dem meine Partner und
I
ich
want to describe the project. We worked
also
in this project for over 2 years. So
danach werde ich etwas zur Historie der
afterwards I talk
in
about
in
the
Jena
history
sagen,
of the climate station in Jena and
danach
about the evaluation and analysis of historic
über die,
measuring
werde,
data.
Mein Partner etwas über die
my partner will talk about the future development of temperature in Jena, and then we talk about temperature characteristic days and also about heat days, and we talk about the field of action, and that's the healthcare system. So we wrote this paper and were supported by the Thuringian Climate Agency. We evaluated long-time historic measuring time series from 1824 until now, and we put these findings of our research into the context of the ongoing climate change, and we studied current climate projections of available regional models for the city of Jena. So the history of the climate station in Jena, it had its 200th anniversary in September 2013. In 1813, it was founded by the Duke and his minister Johann Wolfgang von Goethe. And
zuverlässige Wettervorhersagen gemacht werden.
Because of this we have a long time series. In 1813, the planetarium was built in Jena. And so this weather station still exists today. Since 1889, there were almost no changes. So inside the city center of Jena, there is a meteorology rarity, and we have continuous time series of 200 years time. So this is the most important criteria for reliable statements about climate and the climate change, and that's why we have long-term statements about climatic changes. So when we studied the historic measuring series, we analyzed them from 1824 to 2012. So we studied the mean temperature on a monthly basis, and we also studied the extremes. And later on, we analyzed available climatic models. And we also studied the impact of climate change. So we used maps, and 30 years means then we compared minima and maxima. So this picture that you see here are the most extreme month regarding the monthly mean temperatures. And we also have the time period from 1971 to 2000. So that's our reference. That's what we compare it to. So these are the monthly mean temperature. So the range between the minimum and the maximum is, for example, in February, minus 11 to 7.5 degrees. So that's about 19.3 Kelvin. In June, it's from 15 degrees Celsius in 1844 to 23.5 in 2006. So this is a difference of 8.5 Kelvin. So from the daily measured values, we calculated the yearly means, and so we have a list now of the 10 hottest and 10 coldest years. So 5 of the hottest years with an average temperature from 10.4 to 11.1 are between 2000 and 2011. So this graph shows the development of the yearly mean temperature between 1820 and 2012 in the area of Jena. The linear trend from 1901 to 2010, this is the dotted line. This is the increase of the yearly mean temperature in this time period of 1.5 Kelvin. In the last 30 years, the yearly mean temperature in the area of Jena increased by 1.1 Kelvin. And the blue line shows the 30-year floating mean. So the temperature increase in the last 50 years is about double the amount of the last 100 years. So the increase of the global yearly mean temperature is about 1.5 Kelvin, and the total yearly mean temperature is about 2 Kelvin. So it's a significant change of the climatologic parameter temperature between 1824 and 2012 in the area of Vienna. When we analyze the historic measuring data and also the climate projection data, we looked at the temperature values and temperature characteristic days. For winter, to characterize winter, we used frost days and ice days, and for the summertime, we used heat days and summer days. So heat day or hot day means it's more than 30 degrees Celsius. So a hot day is automatically also a summer day. In order to analyze the historic values, so we have now about double or more than double the amount of hot days.
Von circa 9 Tagen in der Dekade 1911
1911 to 1920, we had 9 days and about 17 hot days between 2001 and 2010. So the historic data confirm our assumption that the higher frequency of this characteristic days of temperature changed significantly. And it's also shown that the number of hot days increases.
Im ausgewählten Handlungsfeld Gesundheitswesen.
And this is very important also for the field of healthcare. But we were also interested in the development of temperature and characteristic days in the future.
An dieser Stelle wäre der Part von der
And this would be the part of Mrs. Feinschmidt. Unfortunately, she is ill, and since we supported this paper, I will participate in this and I will show you the results of Mrs. Feinschmidt.
Sie werden hoffentlich nachsehen, dass es vielleicht manchmal nicht ganz so rund klingt, wie das eben gerade bei der Frau Fleischmann war.
Of course, I'm not used to this paper, but I will give my best. Before I show you the results of the climate projection data, we also, in this paper, we wanted to see the climate change and the current results, the causes of climate change, because of the carbon concentration. So, and you heard about the fifth assessment report of the IPCC, so this is also something special for students, what is the current development, what are the current results and findings, and the significant influence of the carbon emissions for the climate change. So this is the current data. And of course, when we talk about heat, we had to have a look on extreme events. So what happened worldwide? So which special events we had during the last years? Of course, you know this, the record heat in Russia, flood in Pakistan in 2011, the biggest flood in Thailand in 2012. We had a heat wave and a record drought in the United States. And in 2013, we had flood in central Germany and a typhoon in the Philippines in November. Here you can see we used the regional climate model STARS of PIC. So this is based on the global model ECHAM 6 and the RCP scenario 8.5. So you see the daily values from 2010 to 2100. So there are 100 model runs were used, the daily values were calculated, and on the basis of the daily values, also the maximum and minimum temperature, and this was the base for the temperature characteristic days. So summer days, hot days, frost days and ice days. So these are always a decade means and also 30 years means. And this for 100 model runs. All the values you find in this table, it's very comprehensive. You cannot see so much in this table, but as an example, for example, the hot days, the method that was used to analyze it, it was analyzed decade-wise, all decade means, and also 30 years means. They were sorted out for all 100 model runs, and from this total amount of days, calculated heat days, percentiles were formed, 95 percentile, to get out the extreme values and to form a median. So that you can handle all these values. So these results were used
Darstellung oder Grafik zu den historischen Messdaten zu verlängern,
to prolong the graph of the historic measuring data until 2100. You can see it here, the red line is the yearly mean temperature and the gray area, this is the percentile area.
Sie sehen natürlich auch deutlich, wie das je weiter wir in die Zukunft kommen, das auch deutlich nach oben.
The farther we go to the future, it will go further up. So these are the results of the model runs with the model assumptions.
Aus den Medianwerten wurden dann natürlich
the median values were used to show the number of the characteristic days, always in the range of 30 years. So this is the reference time period, and the bars are the median values. And on the top edge you see the percentile, and this is over a time period of 30 years always. So you can see it, how the temperature increases and the number of characteristic days increases when we go further to the future. And the focus was on the heat days, hot days, because they want to use this when they look in the healthcare field for the city of Jena. It's not only the number of characteristic days that changes, but also you see the different periods. So heat events,
definiert als zwei bis vier Tage aufeinanderfolgende Tage, Perioden von Hitzetagen oder
so heat periods of 2 days or more, or five or more days. So the yellow bars, these are the heat events, and red, these are the heat periods. Not only the number of days, but also the duration of this heat period, where the heat stress, of course, is growing also. And it's a similar picture, it increases significantly. And now,
ja, unter dem Aspekt der Zunahme an Sommer- und Hitzetagen, dem Gesamtanstieg der
it means when the summer and heat days increase and the increase of the temperature of 2 degrees Kelvin, we need adaptations in the city of Jena.
Status quo und Potenziale am 13. Juni.
So we took part in a workshop, and we collected material, and we also had some further education in one of the selected topic fields. So the risks and opportunities for the changing climate in the field of healthcare system. So we studied the study of the Jena adaptation strategy. So the coronary system is under a lot of stress, and this leads to an increase of morbidity and mortality, especially with ill people, older people, and children. And also skin cancer increases, and extreme weather events have a high risk for dangerous accidents. So these results of the climate change means that we have to take precautionary measures and we have to adapt to it. So we've seen that the number of hot days doubled. And so we have to minimize and detect risks and harms in order to protect the inhabitants. So we need drinking water supply, especially in children in schools, and when children play and when they do some sports, they have to be in the shade, they have to be protected from sunshine, and small children and ill people cannot adapt to heat events, and that's why especially in hot days and during hot periods, we need people that take care of the people and to help them. It's also important to have further education for the people working in the healthcare system, and also the neighbors should help each other to support elderly people if there are no special healthcare people around. So this is very important. And one of the most effective and most important measure is the information of the people of Jena about climate change and the results of the climate change. And I want to conclude with this slide. So we found out that the climate change in Jena already started. Historic measuring time series show that the temperature already increased significantly, and there will be a higher frequency of extreme heat events. And so this impact of the climate change has to be evaluated in the healthcare system, and they have to be put into practice. Thank you for your attention.
Many thanks, warm thanks for this very interesting and specifically enriching presentation, which concludes our climate days, which is now open to discussion. And I see the first sign, Mr. Sommer. Thank you. Two small questions, one directed to you and one to Mr. Reinhardt. First question, what I'm interested in, what was the task, what was the reason, which was the project, the school project, who was the tutor, and which discipline in school, and Mr. Reinhardt, as to the, why did you use stars for the projection? We try to use Regis also in schools, there are a lot of other models. So what was the background or reason why you actually opted for stars? As already said in the beginning, at our school we had a seminary project, school project to be written, which starts in the 11th level. Certain aspects we ourselves could choose the subject, then we will have consultations, technical consultations. We are supported by the school, our tutors are coached. It's a two-year project which will end up in a kind of thesis and will also end up in an oral colloquium, which is also meant as preparation for the student whether to demonstrate autonomy in dealing with a subject, specific subject, and this is also kind of compensation for not having a 13th year at school as is in other. Yeah, this starts in the 11th grade. This starts in 11th grade, 11th year at school. The state agency for environment and biology of the Thuringian government assisted us. We had technical consultations, we had advisors, interviews, discussions, the graphs were created there, the DWD, German Weather Service, provided the data. As to the use of the STARS data, there are two reasons why we opted for this. First of all, it's very pragmatic. We actually use data from also already available in another project. The second reason is that we actually wanted to use latest climate model outputs in order to gain experience, to see what new results are, what is the correlation, and what is new, because this was also interesting for us as tutors. In one of the main presentations yesterday, we heard information about special impacts of climate change in urban and city areas. One question was whether there is an extent of heat island effects. We know that there are heat island effects in the city, in the urban area. Did you actually compensate for this, or did you accept it like this and did not use them? Since the beginning of our project, for the data series, in the data series there might be a hidden increasing heat island effect over, which is normal for a growing city within 200 years. I was responsible for the historical data and Christiane was responsible for the future data. So only in terms of the past, when we measure 200 years ago, we have the old town of Jena, which was not just growing, let's say, even if it remains the same size, there is an increase in the energetic per capita output and circulation. This is a heating up effect within the city. Did you actually compensate for this? Maybe I could answer this question. The data were taken as they were. We did not actually include any other factors, whether there were urbanizing impacts. So we should have a look at the impacts, because there were bends in between in 1842 up to 1900. We had an up and down, but then we saw a steady increase. So we did not actually investigate into this matter. Yes, and the little ice age story should also be borne in mind. But there is another question or comment. A very simple question. You may have heard it repeatedly. It's a 200-year series. In 1812 was the intended starting point. Goethe and the Duke were all there, but it did not start actually at this point. At that point, there are huge gaps in the data. They would not have been able to be robust enough. So 1824 was a better starting point. You might ask me why starting in 1824, not in 1820, but it's the same reason, because the data were monthly or even included gaps of 2 to 3 years, and so we actually decided to start in 1824. I do not understand the question. I will translate the answer. I'm sorry.
Also aus historischen Aufzeichnungen über die Klimaschutz.
The historical records we saw that on the one hand there were data which went lost or which were never collected. So, but we do not actually know what the reason was.
Sie hatten in der Grafik einen Teil der Säulen schraffiert dargestellt.
Certain bars in the,
gefragt,
in the diagram were grayed out, so to say. Was it due to war?
Yes,
we actually grayed them out, more or less, or we wanted to show that there are gaps within the years identified, because we needed to introduce this in around 1840. These were war impacts, data gaps were created by hostile activities. During those days, the station was removed, relocated, and was used as a quarter for soldiers, and several records went lost due to the war.
I see
no further questions or comments. I myself would like to add a comment while the two are still here on the floor, on the podium. Next year, Julia will make her A level. I hope her colleague, her student, will be healthy again, in good health again. So, applause for your upcoming examinations. All the best for you.